I guess this is structures explained, and in this video we'll be learning about various types of beams used in mechanics. There are basically 6 types of beams used in mechanics. Beams used for finding out reaction on support are assumed to be massless, and support if pinned or roller are frictionless. This is assumed for the sake of easy calculations. Starting from the simplest of the beam, the simply supported beam rests on a pin and roller support. Pin support allows rotation and roller support allows rotation and lateral movement. The deflected shape of the beam in 2D would look something like this on loading. This beam has got 3 unknown reactions, which are vertical reactions at both the support and horizontal reaction at pin support. We have 3 equilibrium equations, which are summation of forces in vertical direction is 0, summation of forces in horizontal direction is 0, and moment about any of the support as 0, to find 3 reactions. Hence it is called a statically determinate beam. Next we are looking at an overhanging beam, in which some portion of the beam extends from support from one side. The deflected shape of the beam on uniform loading between supports would look something like this, in which both the support allow rotation of the beam. If the overhang is from both the ends, then the beam is supposed to be called double overhang, and the deflected shape on uniform loading would look something like this. These arrangements are also statically determined with 3 unknowns and 3 equilibrium equations. Next is fixed beam, which has fixed or rigid support from both the ends. Deflected shape due to uniform loading would look something like this, in which fixed supports will not rotate. Fixed support gives all 3 reactions, which are horizontal, vertical and moment at both supports, hence a total of 6 unknowns. These unknowns cannot be found by 3 equilibrium equations, hence the arrangement is called statically indeterminate. Next we will see a cantilever beam, which is fixed on one side and free on the other side. Deflected shape due to loading will look something like this. This beam has got 3 unknowns, hence they can be found by equilibrium equations, making this beam statically determinate. Next we will see a propped cantilever beam, which is nothing but a cantilever beam with a roller support at the other end. The deflected shape due to loading on the propped cantilever would look something like this. As the total number of unknown reactions are 4, 3 from fixed support and 1 from roller, it will be termed as statically indeterminate beam. But what if I tell you that propped cantilever can be made statically determinate? This can be possible by introducing an internal hinge or pin. Internal hinge allows free rotation, hence moment at that point is 0. Beams to the left and right of the internal hinge can be treated like 2 separate beams for calculations. Deflections due to uniformly distributed load in this case would look something like this. The slope abruptly changes on each side of the hinge. In the real world, shear connection between 2 beams can be assumed as an internal hinge. Next comes a continuous beam, which has 2 or more than 2 spans. The support at the ends may be fixed, pinned, or roller. The ends can be overhanging or supported. Deflected shape of the continuous beam on loading would look something like this. Point to be noted here is that the intermediate support will not allow rotation of the beam, hence there will be some amount of bending moment present at that support. As the unknown reactions in the continuous beams are more than 3, the reaction cannot be statically determined. That's it for this video guys. If you enjoyed this video and found it useful, hit that like button. Comment below your thoughts or questions regarding this video. More such content will follow, so do subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon to get notified for new videos. Also check out our social media pages, links to which are in the description. Thanks for watching, see you in the next one.